Hola, soy Amaya Valdemoro. This is Eurobasket Woman, day 9.
It's the final day of action in the second round for the 6 teams in Group F. Just one place in the quarterfinals left to be filled. And Serbia, knowing that a win over the Czech Republic would be enough to send them through. Their hopes boosted by the return of Ana Dabovic, cleared to play after a knee injury. Would it make a difference? First quarter with the ball, a pull-up jumper for her, it's good. Focus intense. The Czechs, though, playing for places but struggling to get good shots early. There's Petra Kulichova clinging up. But Serbia leaving them in a spin. Milica Dabovic with a game-high 17 points. Close first quarter, but Lubar Blazic seeing his side fall away. A 14-0 run took the Serbians clear in the second period. Up by as much as 28 in the third, a late Czech rally, but it came too late. Serbia convincing, pulling away to secure a 75-59 win and able to celebrate first place in the quarterfinals for 10 years.
Oh, I can't really explain feeling. I hope you can see a little how we feel. I think we are showing better than we're saying, like we are doing on the court, really. We are not talking too much about our team. We are showing, we are fighting, and it was so hard 2 days ago, but we are team, really. My girls helped me come back, and I really didn't even think about my knee. I just came, and I know I wanted to win and be in quarterfinal, and now I'm the happiest person in the world.
Game two halves for the Czechs, and they know they'll need better at the next stage.
For us, it was a hard game. We knew that Serbia have a very strong first half. They go for the ball all the time. They hustle. They try to pressure. And then we kind of fall into that game. And we kind of were like shaky with the ball. In the second half, it was a little bit better. We found each other on the court, and that make us a little bit more confident.
So that win for Serbia killing off Great Britain's hopes of progress, but still out to end up on a winning note against Croatia. There's Jelidim getting hot early on. Here's Jelena Ivicic. The leads traded places in the opening 8 minutes. GB yet to make their move. Steph Gandhi with the jumper. Now the long pass picked up by Iva Stiskovic, helping to put Croatia up by 5 in the first quarter. Their lead, though, didn't last, leading with an outstanding game. 26 points, 10 rebounds, and 9 assists for the guard. There's one of those killer passes, finding Chantal Handy. A huge 16-0 run, taking the British clear. They led by as much as 17. Croatia cut it to 2, lay on as good as it got. Great Britain leaving France victorious by 85-79.
It was a really tough game emotionally, but you know, we pulled through in the end and we finished on a high and did our country proud in the end. Just this elite level, and you got to come to play. You can't leave your fate in other people's hands. Every game you've got to just be hungry for it, and it's 40 minutes here. You can't play 35, it has to be 40.
Croatia not able to match their run to the quarterfinals of 2 years ago and disappointment with their tournament.
We lost 5 games, only won one. We definitely didn't come here to do that. And we're going home. There's a lot of things to work, and tough competition is ahead of us next year. We have to qualify again for a tournament like this, and it's going to be hard. We have to go back and start from the groundwork and the basics. And but I'm sure, like, in order to be on top, you have to be on the bottom first.
So with quarterfinal berths sorted, the fans in Vendée hoping to see France remain unbeaten and clinch first place with a win over Belarus. Certainly wasn't coming early on very easily, their path blocked. Yandro Chachuang with the jumper here, trying to get France going. And those fans lending their support as well. Anastasia Veremienko with some resistance with that jumper. Belarus still level in the second period. One key figure constantly driving late blue forward, Celine Dumerc hitting the jumper. But here comes Katerina Snitsia, team high 16 points. Belarus only 6 behind at the half. Some questions being asked from the hosts. Sandrine Gruda with one answer, a block there, add on 18 points for her. Just 2 points the difference in the third quarter, but a 13-0 run finally killing off Belarus' hopes. France congratulating each other, they move on with a 58-50 victory, but despite the euphoria, certainly their toughest test to date. But as they depart Vendée for the knockout stages in Orsi, the fans here giving them a rising send-off.
No, it was really, really hard, really tough game, and we need that. We need to stay concentrated, focused 40 minutes, and we need to push ourselves and to fight 40 minutes. Also, a crowd like that is amazing to play here, really.
Belarus will take on either Spain or Turkey in the next round, but they'll take some hope from this performance.
We watch games what France played before. They 20-30 points. They play very good. We wasn't scared. It's just a game. We just know something what we must stop, like fast break or minimum turnovers. But we make mistakes. They score. They're a good team. So it just was a good game. But today we lost.
So let's round up all of Sunday's results. Serbia sparkling against the Czech Republic. Great Britain with one last win over Croatia to get their best ever placing at a Eurobasket. And France surviving against Belarus. And there are the final standings in Group F. France unbeaten still at Eurobasket Women. Serbia taking second place ahead of Belarus on the head-to-head tiebreaker. Same for the Czechs over Britain for fourth. And Croatia ending up in sixth spot. Monday slate and the second round coming to a close in Lille, and Spain and Turkey going head to head. One of those teams set to lose their 100% record in the competition. And behind them, four sides battling it out for just two spots remaining in the quarterfinals. A win for Italy will be enough. They face Montenegro and Sweden up against Slovakia. It promises to be an exciting end to the group stages. Make sure you follow it all at FIBAEurope.com. We'll be right back.